It's past noon already. Nothing is going to happen. I want you to leave this place now.
I can't go, Father, because the lady said she'd be here.
You've done harm enough. Do as I tell you.
This is my property, Father. You have no right to order my daughter away from here.
From heaven.
This is the sign, a flood of rain.
No, wait, Our Lady was there. I didn't see her, but I know it.
Ah, three crazy children.
We were cheated.
The sign, show us the sign.
Listen to them.
Why don't you leave them alone? They're only children. Go on, go away. Go on.
Show us the sign.
Come to us, dear lady. What do you want?
I want to tell you that the war is going to end soon, and the soldiers will return to their homes. Do not fear. In the end, God will triumph.
You said you'd tell us who you are.
I am the Lady of the Rosary.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary.
Where's Our Lady? We haven't seen her.
A child talking to the empty air.
We saw nothing, heard nothing.
They better pull some sort of miracle out of the hat, or this farce will become a tragedy.
Well, I can't say we didn't try to stop it.
We've been cheated. We've been lied to.
Nobody touches the children.
Holy Mother, you promised to give us a miracle so the people will believe us. I can see it. lady kept her promise.
It's also dry.
The earth is dry.
It's dry.
My clothes are dry.
Mama, look.
Oh, Papa, you know that river.
So are ours.
Just the blood.
Only the fool saith, there is no God.
The official Nagasaki atomic bomb Ground Zero is shown by the Black Column Monument, which is in the center of rings or a target bullseye. Extremely noteworthy is the Urikami Cathedral surviving statues, which are also within the target bullseye rings. The Nagasaki Ground Zero Monument communicates a powerful hidden message.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Cullman Hall of the Universe of the American Museum of Natural History. All right. I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, the Frederick P. Rose Director of the Hayden Planetarium. And this is a press conference, a literal press conference, where it's open to whatever passerby wants to eavesdrop, where we are cluing the press into what will be happening on August 21st as the moon passes between Earth and the sun, and does so only for Americans, only for residents of the northern, of the continental United States will get to experience totality.
But it's okay because I get to present to you one of the most exciting events that has happened across the soil of the United States in recent memory. So I'm going to take a couple of minutes and describe what you're going to get to see and the things that will be going on here at the American Museum of Natural History during the eclipse. Neither the sun or the moon know what's up right now. Right now, it's just us sitting here talking about it. They don't know what it's about to happen. What's about to happen is that the moon goes around the Earth goes around the sun. And I'll show you a video of this in just a second. We've got a screenshot of this really beautiful simulation that we've made for you of the event by the software that we have here at the museum. So, moon's going around the Earth, Earth's going around the sun. They're not perfect with each other, though. The moon's orbit around the Earth is off by a couple of degrees from how the moon and the Earth system is going around the sun. So as a result, this is a fairly non-frequent occasion. It happens every 18 months or so that we get this total solar eclipse that's going to happen. So let's start the video and start explaining what's going to happen here. So first, this is the UniView software that we have here at the museum. We use this all the time in our planetarium dome. And as they start the video, what you're going to see is a picture of what it looks like. Say if we were able to fly out off the surface of the Earth and have a look at the moon and the sun and the Earth together. And during this period of time, during a total solar eclipse, you get the moon lined up perfectly between the Earth and the sun. So, how many people have ever looked at your own shadow? Let's see a raise of hands of shadows. You guys feel familiar with your shadow? You feel comfortable with it? Well, on the day of August 21st, we are hosting the shadow of the moon across the United States. So here's a little pullout where we're kind of orbiting around. You saw the Earth, Moon, Sun system there. The sun, by the way, is about 93 million miles away, plus or minus. The moon is far less than that, 250,000, 280,000 miles away or so. That means that the moon is about 400 times closer to the Earth than the sun is. And as it happens, the sun is also about 400 times larger than the moon is. That's why you can walk outside and they'll look about the same size in the sky, if you've ever noticed that. So on the day, I had mentioned that the orbits are off by about 5 degrees. They're actually crossing the node of the moon going around the Earth and the Earth going around the sun. So we've done this little simulation where you can see this dark shadow that's passing. The red dots are showing you cities as it crosses. We'll run the simulation one more time. So it's going to start in Oregon, and it's going to make its way across towards South Carolina.